99.9 KEKB with the Charlie Daniels Band. Waylon with you here. It is my pleasure to once again get to speak with Charlie Daniels. How you doing today?
Good, Waylon. How you doing, buddy?
I am doing great, and we are so excited to see you back in Grand Junction coming up Thursday. That's Thursday, April 14th, the historic Avalon Theatre. That's the way I want to see you. What a venue. What an act. Now, I was just watching an interview with you. First of all, are you in, you're on the road right now, Battle Creek, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm in Battle Creek, Michigan right now. Okay. Absolutely.
You're going to be coming to us and then Parker on the 17th. I'm sorry, you're going to say?
No, I was just going to say, this is a busy time of year for us. This is when we got our year to get started, and we'll be busy from about now till middle of December, something like that.
Right. I was watching your tour schedule. It's incredibly busy, but I'm gathering that I've seen you so many times. I gather that you live for the live show. Is that right?
I love it. That's what keeps me in this business, is playing live for people. I'm addicted to it. I really am.
Wow, what a great way to say it, addicted. But you're also, I saw an interview with you recorded 2 days ago. You're in the studio as well, aren't you?
Yeah, well, we've been working on an album. I've been wanting to do an album of cowboy songs, not so much the recognizable ones, but there's a lot of obscure cowboy songs out there that I don't think people have ever heard, or most people have ever heard. And I want to record some of them. They're working cowboy songs, but we finally got around to it. We just finished it up for yesterday, in fact.
I see. Now, you can check that out on YouTube. So some studio work going on. I did a little math. I crunched some numbers. My math is normally not very reliable, but you were writing tunes and doing session work. But by my math, this is your 43rd year charting as a solo artist. Does that sound about right?
That sounds about right. You know, I never really kept up with it on those terms, but that sounds, yeah, I think you did. I think you did some good homework there, pardon. Okay.
But you did a lot of great session work. Is there anything you ever recorded we don't know about?
Probably.
Oh, yeah? Maybe there's like a...
I did a duet with George Jones one time.
Yeah,
he did do it album. I did a duet with him. I've done, I've done things through the years. I spent the day in New York years ago doing with Bob Dylan and George Harrison of the Beatles and a drummer named Russ Kunkel. And they just went in the studio for the fun of it, basically. And I happened to be in town. They asked me to come by and play. And none of the stuff could be released or was supposed to be released. I think they have since then, because George didn't have a green card or whatever it takes to, you know, to be legal. So we just went in and spent the day jamming. That was a lot of fun. I wish I had a copy of this stuff.
And in regards to the new album or the new material, when could we expect that?
The Cowboy album, we're going to get it on out pretty quick. Sometime in the next couple of months, I would think. I don't have an exact date on it, but we got the album cover shot, and we're ready to roll with it. So as soon as your post-production work's done, the mixing and that sort of thing, we'll turn her loose.
And will we hear any of that material Thursday night?
No, not this particular, not that soon. I'm not quite ready to do it yet. I haven't really learned it that well. You know, you go in the studio and you're getting, you're not quite ready to put it out before the public, because you do your recordings in bits and pieces. So you sometimes, when you go in the studio, you actually got to learn a song all over again before you do it on stage.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, we're going to see you coming up Thursday, April 14th at the historic Avalon Theater. Head over to KEKBFM.com. There's precisely like 2 tickets left. Get those at Back Porch Music on Independent Avenue. Going to chat with Charlie Daniels again in just a moment. So stick around. 99.9 KEKB. 99.9 KEKB with the Charlie Daniels Band. Coming up Thursday, April 14th. Charlie Daniels Band coming to Grand Junction to the historic Avalon Theater. It's always going to be a great show. Now here at KEKB, we've hosted you in concert so many times. And it's always, always top notch. You're one of probably the most energetic entertainers in the world. And you said earlier you're addicted to it. Would you do this forever?
As long as it's the good Lord's will and people want to hear me, I'll be out here. My hero is little Jimmy Dickens. He did this into his 90s.
Right.
And I would very much like to think I could do the same thing, because I do thoroughly enjoy it.
That's outstanding. Now, you spend a pretty good part of your life in Colorado, do you not? You have a home here.
I do, yeah. We do have a home over in the Four Corners area, and we spend usually about 2 months a year there, give or take, depending on my work schedule.
Now, when we see you at the Avalon Theater, will you have copies of your book available? Ain't No Rag, Freedom, Family, and the Flag. Would you happen to have those?
Yes. I don't know exactly what our merchandise guy's carrying now, but I'm pretty sure he's carrying some of those. I don't know if he's got them all or not, but he's carrying part of them anyway.
And if someone had a copy of that, would you be willing to sign it?
Yeah, sure. Maybe I'll sign it. Yeah, absolutely. I'll sign anything.
Very cool.
I can't even sign a blank check because my wife signs all mine. I don't think they take mine.
If I may, I'd like to field a question from one of our listeners, Dakota Ray McKinnon. I hope you're okay with this. She asks, I would like to ask, what is his most memorable moment with Merle Haggard, and did he have a favorite song that they played together?
Really didn't have a favorite song that we played together. We never actually played on the same bill, but never actually jammed together. Merle lived in Bakersfield, over on the other coast, and which I live in Tennessee, so we didn't run into each other socially. We're so far away, but once in a while we'd work together, and I'm a great admirer of Merle's work. He was one of a kind, and there'll never be another Merle Haggard. The Lord only made one of those. That's it.
Mm-hmm. And of course, we were devastated when we heard the word here 2 days ago. And I saw that interview with you, and that was a great interview on YouTube. I encourage people to swing over. Nice lengthy interview with you on that topic. So coming up, we're going to see you this Thursday at the historic Avalon Theater. Could I ask you to throw out a handful of tunes that we could expect?
Yeah. That went down to Georgia, long hair country boy. Lakes of the Woody Swamp. You know the routine.
Oh, yeah. We love it, too. We can't get enough of the Charlie Daniels Band. Is there anybody you'd like to throw out some kudos to? Any of your guys? Any sponsors?
To everybody who has ever listened to Charlie Daniels' tune or ever bought a record or ever come to see a concert, I am so thankful to you because you made my life a dream, and I really do appreciate it.
We can't wait to see you. We love you here in Western Colorado. The Charlie Daniels Band coming to the historic Avalon Theater. That is coming up this Thursday, April 14th. Get all your details. Do not miss this show. Everything you need, KEKBFM.com. I wish you a great show this Thursday. Tonight, you are playing in Battle Creek, Michigan tonight. Have a great show, please.
Thank you, my friend. God bless.
Thank you. Coming back at 99.9 KEKB.